Updating some late breaking news, a crane collapses at a metro hospital.
KOCO's Wendell Edwards is right there where it all came crashing down. And Wendell, what happens next in all this?
It's the cleanup part. What's next, Paul? Look at this. I want to let you show this is part of the crane. This is quite heavy, so you can just imagine how much damage was done. If you take a look behind me, there still is a lot of cleanup left to do. From above, the scene is very clear. A huge crane lying on its side.
You can see the high lines behind us, the electric lines, and it just barely missed all of those. The yard we're standing in here has a lot of kids' toys, and there wasn't anybody out here, nobody home at the time.
The crane's operator attempted to replace a cooling unit at Deaconess Hospital when something went terribly wrong. Both tipped over. The unit crashed three cars in the parking lot, and this crane landed in the backyard, flattening this fence. Rent-A-Crane operates this machinery, and this isn't their first accident. We check records and learn OSHA fined the company back in 2010 for a crane accident that left one man dead. Today, no one was hurt, but
I'm not a crane expert. I'm sure some type of mistake was made, whether it was human or mechanical, and I'm sure they'll be figuring that out.
Figuring it out so it won't happen again. And just to make sure you understand, they actually had to bring in another crane to upright the one that tipped over. And that's exactly what happened just about 10 minutes ago. You can see the words Rent-A-Crane on that particular crane. That was the one that fell over. And speaking of Rent-A-Crane, we did call the company. We left a message for the CEO, but he did not return our phone calls. But we're live tonight on the Northwest Side. Wendell Edwards, KOCO Eyewitness News 5.
Okay, Wendell, now we can tell you the crane operator was not injured in that accident.